I'm Dr. M. Kalpana Devi, working as an assistant professor, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Government College of Engineering, Sengipatti, Tanjavur. Last semester, we learnt about microprocessor and microcontroller. In this semester, we have to see the embedded system. Here, you go with the embedded system syllabus. Unit 1, Introduction to Embedded System. Unit 2, Embedded Networking. Unit 3, Embedded Firmware Development Environment. Unit 4, RTOS Based Embedded System Design. Unit 5, Embedded System Application and Development. The Unit 1 contains Introduction, Structural Units in Embedded Processor, Selection of Processor and Memory Devices, DMA, Memory Management Methods, Timer and Counting Devices, Watchdog Timer, Real-Time Clock, In-Circuit Emulator, Target Hardware Debugging Circuits. So these are the topics under Unit 1. You already know what is microprocessor or what is microcontroller. Both are semiconductor device that are manufactured using LSI, MSI, VLSI or VVLSI technology. It includes microprocessor as CPU, memory, input devices and output devices. In the case of microcontroller, some peripheral devices are fabricated on the same IC chip, that is microcontroller. Let us see what is an embedded system. First, let us talk about a system. A system is a way of working, organizing or doing one or many tasks according to a fixed plan, program or set of rules. The system is also an arrangement in which all its units assembled and worked together in accordance with a plan or program. This is called system. Let us see what is an embedded system. An embedded system is a system that has embedded software and computer hardware, which makes it a system dedicated for an application or specific part of an application or part of a larger system. Here, I think two best simple examples. The first one is watch. Everyone is using this watch. To see the time, look at the rules. The first rule is all needles move clockwise only. A thin needle rotates every second. A long needle rotates every minute. A short needle rotates every hour. All needles return to the original position after 12 hours. Already I have said that the system is nothing but it is a way of working, organizing or doing one or many tasks according to a fixed plan, program or set of rules. According to this rules, the program has been developed and this program or software is embedded in the controller chip, that is called embedded processor. The second example is a washing machine. Now, for a few days, most people use a washing machine to wash their clothing. See the rules. Rule number one, wash by spinning, then rinse, then drying, then fourth rule is wash over by blinking, then each step display the process stage, then after that, in case if any interruption, execute only the remaining rules. According to these rules, the program has been built and this program or software is embedded in the controller chip, that is called embedded processor. So, embedded system is a system that has embedded software and computer hardware that makes it a system dedicated to an application or specific part of an application or product or part of a larger system. See the diagram. The processing element may be microprocessor or microcontroller or digital signal processor or application specific integrated circuit or programmable logic device or field programmable gate array or even system on a chip, that is SoC. So these devices act as brain for any system or machine. So this intelligent chip, that is software, is embedded on the chip, is used for that application. So these are the applications of embedded system. Almost every field uses embedded system, like automotive electronics, aircraft electronics, railways, telecommunication, then medical system, then military applications, then authentication circuits, consumer electronics, fabrication equipment, smart buildings, then robotics, and the list goes on. This slide shows the detailed application of embedded system. That is the consumer electronics examples, then medical electronics examples, then remote automation, then industrial controls, then automotive electronics, then military applications, then telecom, then automation. So these are all broad embedded system applications. So this slide shows the important characteristics of an embedded system. The first one is perform a specific task, that is the embedded system performs some specific functions or task. Then second point is a low cost, the price of the embedded system is not so expensive. Third one is time specific. So time specific means it executes the task within a time limit. Then fourth one is a low power. So low power means embedded system do not need a lot of power to run. Then fifth point is a high efficiency. The efficiency level of embedded system are so high. Then sixth one, minimal user interface. So minimal user interface means the system require less user interface and are easier to use. Then seventh one, less human intervention. So that means embedded system do not need human intervention or even less human intervention. Then highly stable. So highly stable means embedded system does not change frequently, mostly fixed, maintaining stability, that is called a highly stable. Then highly reliability means embedded system are highly reliable and perform the task reliability well. Then use of microprocessor or microcontroller, that is embedded system use microprocessor or microcontroller for the design, and use of limited memory. So these are all the characteristics of an embedded system. So in this video we see the what is system, then what is embedded system with the examples, then what are the applications, then broad embedded system applications, then characteristics of an embedded system. Thank you.